Let's take our next question, that is question number 22. Now the question you see here belongs to the section of electromagnetism from chapter current electricity. As per the question, for the circuit shown with R1 equals to 1 ohm, R2 is equals to 2 ohm, E1 as 2 volt and E2, E3 both at 4 volt, the potential difference between the points A and B has been asked. So for this we can use a direct relation, but we need to understand first that this is 2 volt, this is 4 volt and this is 4 volt, right? Now this being 1 ohm, this is 1 ohm. Together these two can be merged as they are in series and they can be treated as the internal resistance of this cell as 2 ohm. Then for this R2, this is also 2 ohm. This can also be treated as internal resistance of this second cell. And here this 1 ohm and this 1 ohm, R1's value is 1 ohm. So together they are in series. So this can also be treated as 2 ohm. So now I have 3 cells with 3 EMFs and all have internal resistance of 2 ohm. So now it's easy to solve by the help of a single formula. In that case, the potential difference we are seeking would be E1 R2 R3 plus E2 R1 R3 plus E3 R1 R2 divided by, this should be divided by the all combinations of R, that is R1 R3 plus R2 R3 plus R1 R2. Now we just have to put the values here and we will get the answer, that is V equals to, let's put on the values, E1 is 2 into 2 into 2 plus 4 2 into 2 plus 4 2 into 2, and this whole should be divided by 2 into 2 plus 2 into 2 plus 2 into 2. When you solve this, you will get V as 10 by 3 volts. Let's see which is the best suited option here. So among the four options given here, option number 4 would be the right answer. Hope you have understood this question. Now let's move on to our next question. The question number 23. This question belongs to heat and thermodynamics. Here, two identical beakers A and B contain equal volumes of two different liquids at 60 degrees centigrade each, and they are left to cool down. Liquid in A has density of this value and the specific heat of 2000 joule per kilogram per Kelvin, while the liquid B has a density of 10 to the power 3 kg per meter cube and specific heat of 4000. Which of the following best describes their temperature versus time graph or schematically? So let's see here what are the graphs given. Out of these we have to find which is the best suited option. Among all, it is one common thing that all will start from 60 degree. Now we have to see the rate of cooling down. So in order to understand this, you must know the formula. That is heat loss, ms dT upon dT, that is equals to E sigma A T power 4, right? So from here you can understand that dT by dT, that is equals to minus of E sigma A T power 4, this T is the surroundings temperature, divided by M into S, this is the specific heat. From here you have two liquids A and B. If you understand that dT by dT for A, that is rate of change of temperature of A to rate of change of temperature of B, first of all their slope would be negative. That's why you can see in the options. So as you can see in all the options that all of them are going downwards, that means slope is negative for all the cases, that means it's true. Now if you see here, you will find that the ratio will be mass of B into specific heat of B divided by mass of A into specific heat of A. Since the volume for both liquids B and A are same, that means this rate will be dependent on the density ratio and the specific heat ratios, right? Now for the density part, the density of B has been given to you as 10 to power 3 and this has been 8 into 10 to power 2, whereas this has been given to you as 4000 divided by 2000. So if you just relate them, that is rate of cooling of A to rate of cooling of B, you will find that this ratio is greater than 1. So cooling rate of A will be higher than that of cooling rate of B. So for any given duration of time, the change of temperature will be more for A than that of B. So let's see which is the best suited option here. Among the four options given, if you understand, here is the case option number 2, where for a given instant of time, the rate of change of temperature of A is higher. So answer to this question would be option number 2, right? Now let's move on to our next question, that is question number 24. Now as this question you see, this belongs to section of electromagnetism of chapter electrostatics, capacitance and potential. Here a solid conducting sphere having charge Q is surrounded by an uncharged conducting hollow spherical shell. Let potential difference between the surface of solid sphere and that of outer surface of the hollow shell be V. Now if the shell is now given a charge of minus 4q, the new potential difference between the same two surfaces is. Pretty obvious, the question is standard, it is repeated many a times, but let's solve it again for you. So when you start with the solution, question says that there are two concentric, one is the solid which is inside, right, and one is the, this is the outer one, right? And since they are concentric, let's make them concentric. So this is somewhat concentric. Now this is the solid part, where let's mark this as A point and let's mark this as B point. Radius of the inner one will be X and radius of the outer one, let's take it as Y. Now what is the charge given here? That is capital Q. Now there's no charge on the outer surface, so at this point of time the potential difference V would be equal to VA minus VB. It would be equals to K Q upon X minus K Q upon Y, as the outer shell does not have any charge, right? And even with the induction of charge, there will be no different answer to this. Now when after some time an other charge minus Q is given here, so let's take minus Q here. So if I introduce minus 4Q, now what will happen? So V dash, after adding the charge minus 4Q, you will have VA dash minus VB dash. What would be the value of V dash? So it would be KQ by X, it will remain as it is, plus K into minus 4Q divided by Y. This would be potential of A, the new potential of A, right? Now talking about potential of B, it would be KQ upon Y due to this inner charge and due to the outer charge, that is K into minus 4Q by Y, right? When you solve this one, what you will get? It's pretty amazing to understand, it would be again coming to KQ by X minus KQ by Y. So when you compare the two equations, that is the second equation and the first equation here, that is this one, let's take this as first equation, answer to both are same. That means among the four options, option number 2 is the right answer to this question. I hope you have understood this one easily. Now let's move on to our next question, that is question number 25.